on click, we want this to happen. How do we do it? Three things. We're going to add the Lottie animation, we'll set up the trigger, then we'll set up the animation. Okay, for the first part, we have a blank page here. All we've done is set the background color to black. In our assets panel, we've already uploaded the Lottie animation we exported from After Effects. Let's drag it in right into our page body and let's center it. With the body element selected, we can use science and technology to align and justify our animation to the center. If we preview our page, we can see the animation plays immediately on load, but that's not quite right. That's part one. Part two, let's set up the interaction. So instead of animating when the page loads, the animation plays on click. Over in interactions, this is where it says interactions, we can add our trigger. We're going to make sure the animation itself is selected, not the body or anything else, because we want that element, the Lottie animation element, to serve as the trigger. What kind of trigger? An element trigger, something that triggers our animation on mouse click or tap. This is where we set up the animation. On first click, we'll want to select our Lottie option from the dropdown. This means on click, the Lottie animation will play. Too good to believe, let's test in preview. When we load the page, it's at the start of the animation. When we click it, that's it. So we brought in the animation, set the element trigger on click, and made sure the Lottie animation played properly. Then we summarized everything, and Greemer finished the edit just in time.